is not the smoke that you want. Because this is fifth gear right here, bud. That's fifth gear right there. All right, I'm going to chill, y'all. Yet again, another episode of J.I. Productions. It's your boy J.I. and I'm back at it again with another banger for you guys. Now, as you guys see in the title and the thumbnail, your boy got his first speeding ticket. You know what I'm saying? So, as of right now, my court date is not capped. It's right here, speeding ticket. Not gonna show y'all how fast I was going right now. You know what I'm saying? The video just started. I gotta hold y'all off a little bit, you know what I'm saying? Get this watch time up, you feel me? But anyway, yeah, man, I got my first speeding ticket. And right now, we are on our way, leaving class right now to try to see if I can make it to the courthouse before 9 o'clock to try to see about getting this joint dismissed. Because I ain't even gonna cap. The police officer was on bullshit. He trying to say that he had me clocked. When, bro, I literally had just left a red light and pulled into a neighborhood. You feel me? I was on my way to school. Let me give y'all some background. I was on my way to school, man. And I was leaving an intersection. Literally was at a red light, leaving the intersection. And went up the road just a, like literally like not even 5 minutes. Like 3 minutes up the road and turned into a neighborhood. And the police officer got behind me and was like, oh, you were speeding, blah, blah, blah. I clocked you at this mile per hour and the speed limit is 40. So give me your license and registration or whatever. Not even. He was like, just give me your license and insurance. And he was like, go ahead and sign in this box right here. Like, bro already had everything ready. You feel me? He knew he was going to give me a ticket. So it just doesn't make sense to me how the hell you got all that ready, you know what I'm saying, on their little device where they got to enter in the information of the ticket, and then you got to sign, I guess, in, like, acknowledgement that, you know, you got the ticket and you're going to take care of it. Yeah, bro. Bro already had that joint ready. Like, he didn't have to go back to the car or nothing, bro. So, with that being said, I know bro was just trying to get your boy. You know what I'm saying? It's the end of the month. They trying to meet that quota. It is what it is. Black Mustang, paper tags, riding through the neighborhood. Of course. You know what I'm saying? Easy target. So, right now, we got about a 30-minute drive to the courthouse. Let me go ahead and turn my navigation on real quick because I'm recording on my phone still. So I'll be with y'all in 1 second. But yeah, man, you know what I'm saying? Got the GPS going now. We're good. Like I was saying, y'all, he had everything ready for the kid, man. He was ready to give your boy that ticket. So it is what it is, you know what I'm saying? I'm not really too much tripping on it. We're on our way to the courthouse right now. I'm hoping that because my court date wasn't set today, it was set for tomorrow, that buddy ass not even gonna show up. And 9 times out of 10, they'll dismiss it. That's normally what happens when you get a ticket. You know what I'm saying? At least I've been told. This is my first ticket ever, bro. Literally, I've been through about 7 cars now, I want to say, give or take. And this is my first ever speeding ticket, bro. It's insane. So yeah, man, I guess I'll go ahead and tell you guys how much buddy claims that he clocked me at. So bro say that I was doing 50 and a 40, which legitimately to me doesn't make any sense, bro. Because one, if you caught me doing 50 and I'm turning into a neighborhood, how is that possible? Two, it's just 10 miles over the speed limit. And if I'm not mistaken, I was told that there's a little bit of a grace period in Texas, about a 15-mile grace period over the speed limit. So if you're going like 15 miles per hour over the speed limit, so say I was going 55, then you know what I'm saying, then that's when they would pull you over and give you a ticket. But like if you're doing under 15 miles per hour over, then I was told that it wasn't an issue. But yeah, man, buddy claims that he clocked me or whatever, and on the ticket it says that he used his dash cam and his body camera or whatever. So either way it goes, you would literally be able to see that there was no way buddy clocked me, you know what I'm saying, doing 50 and no 40. Because, bro, there's no, like, the road, there's nowhere for you to park off to the side, you feel me? Unless you pull in the neighborhood. And that's literally what I was doing, pulling in the neighborhood. So there's no way that you sat there and clocked me doing 50, bro. You know what I'm saying? It's all bad cap. But it is what it is. We're on our way right now to try to see if we can get that joint beat. But, and on another note, you know what I'm saying? If you guys have been in the loop with all of the videos, then you guys would know that we recently installed the Eibach Sport lowering springs on the car. And at first we were having a little bit of, you know, vibration and excess road noise after the install on the first drive. You know, check out that video as well. The both will be linked at the end of this video, so make sure you guys go tap in with those joints. But yeah, man, we were having a little bit of a rattling noise. I ended up pinpointing the noise when I retraced my steps, going back and, you know, checking all the bolts and whatnot. And it was actually one of the, I think, upper control arm bolts from in the rear on the passenger side, because that's literally where I was hearing the noise. I checked the shock, the strut, everything was good on the strut, everything was tight. Checked the end links and everything, and that's what you guys saw in the video. Well, if you, you know what, I'm not even gonna say too much. Make sure you guys go tap in with that video, man. It'll be linked at the end of this video, and I probably already put the card up once. But yeah, man, we're on our way to the courthouse right now. The car has been running great with the new Next Grady Stage 4 twin disc clutch, paired with the Eibach lowering springs. The car is running pretty good, man. I'm not even gonna lie, I haven't been able to get on it or anything like that, so I can't tell y'all. But you know, around my house there's a lot of windy roads, and I will say this, the car does feel planted. It feels pretty good. I got some things coming to go ahead and fix the fitment issues that we're having, because I ain't even gonna lie, the wheels are, they're tucking, but they're not flush with the fender, and I want them to be flush with the fender. So we gonna make some stuff shake before the new wheels get here. And I'm telling y'all, when y'all see the new wheels plus the suspension, you dig what I'm saying? Shout out to my boys ATRD, you dig? But I'm telling y'all, bro, it's gonna look nasty. It's gonna be a very nasty setup with a big needy tire in the rear, you know what I'm saying? I'm telling y'all, just stay tuned. If you haven't already, smash that subscribe button, bro, and turn on those post notifications to join the JI squad, man. Cause I'm telling y'all, new car, new content, we're going up. We're at 1,223 miles right now on the break-in. We got less than 400 miles to go to get to that 1,600 mark. And then it'll be time to go ahead and get some pulls in and whatnot.
5 minutes later.
This is not the smoke that you want. Because this is fifth gear right here, bud. That's fifth gear right there. All right, I'm going to chill, y'all. Take the car down to the track and see what she does. Also, I did get a new part for the car, man. Huge shout out to my boy Black Boy Lando. You guys stay tuned for that install video. Your boy Bless the Kid with a little temporary part until my actual, you know, part gets here. So I'm telling y'all, man, this build's about to get real crazy now that we get almost done, you know, getting all the maintenance and stuff taken care of. We are fit to snap, bro, as far as performance and just all the other modifications, man, the aesthetic modifications, all that, man. And then I actually just read a comment from one of you guys. Wow, y'all see this, right? Anyway, I just read a comment from one of you guys telling me that I don't have to drop the transmission to install the NGW short throw shifter. And I really like the sound of that. I hope it's true, man, because I could definitely go ahead and grab that joint and do the install as soon as possible. Because I ain't even gonna lie, I do want to go to the drag strip with the stock shifter and see how it feels, you know, making a pass. But I do want to get that short throw shifter in just to have it, man. So with that being said, y'all, I'm finna go ahead and cruise over to the courthouse. I want to check my GPS real quick and see if I'm on the right track. And I'll tap in with you guys in a little later. He's so lucky that I'm not done with my break-in miles. Because I'm telling you, buddy. This is not the smoke that you want. Because this is fifth gear right here, bud. That's fifth gear right there. All right, I'm going to chill, y'all. Quick little update, y'all. Just made it to the downtown part of the city, you feel me? About 4 minutes away from the courthouse. Just waiting on this light, man. This thing is running great, bro. I can't cap. And I need gas. Alright, y'all. Pulling up to the courthouse right now. I've been here one time before for a different incident. I know I'm gonna have to pay for parking, which is fucking stupid. But y'all go ahead and leave a like right now. You know what I'm saying? Positive vibes only. So your boy beats this freaking case. I would highly appreciate it. If you dig. Well, I'm gonna go ahead and park this joint and grab a ticket and see if I can get this ticket dismissed, man. Sheesh. Gotta pay $5 to park. Shit, crazy. Got the stain and then that view. Sheesh. They got a wide body scat pack that say police on it, bro. Houston ain't playing. Courthouse. Sheesh. Uh-oh, jaywalking in front of the courthouse. Don't give me another ticket.
1 hour later.
Well, boys, beautiful skyline as y'all can see. But your boy took an L today. You know what I'm saying? Got all the paperwork right here. I got to do defensive driving courses or whatever. Even though the cop didn't show up, which is weird to me, but it is what it is. At least my record's gonna stay clean. Shit's gonna get dismissed. I have till January 22nd to go ahead and do the shit. That shit is crazy. I was not speeding though. That's the craziest part, bro. You feel me? Like, it's literally like impossible for me to have sped in the area where he said I did. But look at the stain with that city skyline in the back. Oh, I wish I had my camera, bro. It would look so much better. I'm gonna get a couple pictures though. For you. In the car now, boys. You dig what I'm saying? Got some pictures for the Instagram. If you guys aren't following me already, make sure you guys go tap in. JI Productions _. Man. Kind of bummed about having to take this defensive driving bullshit because it's a 6-hour class and I'm just now finishing school, bro. And now I gotta go back to school. It's like that shit just follows me, dog. You know what I'm saying? But nevertheless, man, you know, we got the beautiful Houston skyline behind us for this outro today. And we, you know, we're going to have a clean record at the end of all of this. So we're not tripping on it too much. It is what it is. You guys do me a favor, though. Go ahead and smash that subscribe button and turn on those post notifications. Drop a comment in the comment section down below and give this video a big thumbs up, bro. Help my analytics, please, because your boy need to make that bread back. That 144, yeah, that's about that YouTube check as of right now. So y'all go ahead and give your boy a thumbs up down in the comment section down below, man. But that's going to be it for this one. I'll see y'all in the next one. Peace. You can't even see my damn fingers. Sheesh.